That's my grandfather, Lord Rickard. He was burned alive by the Mad King Aerys. That's Lyanna, my father's sister. King Robert was supposed to marry her, but Rhaegar Targaryen kidnapped her.
The last time I was in the capital was many years ago. Another wedding. My sister Elia and Rheagar Targaryen, the last dragon. My sister loved him. And beautiful, noble Rheagar Targaryen left her for another woman. That started a war, and the war ended right here.
Your aunt Lyanna, Lord Went of the great tourney at Harrenhall. The last two riders were Barristan Selmy and Rheagar Targaryen. When Rhaegar won, he rode right past his wife, and he lay a crown of winter roses in Lyanna's lap. And all the smiles died. I've never seen so many people so quiet.
Robert started a war to win her back. He killed Rhaegar, but she died anyway.
Did you have to bury her in a place like this? She should be on a hill somewhere with the sun and the clouds above her.
She was my sister. This is where she belongs.
She belonged with me. In my dreams, I kill him every night.
It's done, Your Grace. Targaryens are gone.
Do you know what happened to the Targaryen children when the Mad King fell?
They were butchered in the sleep.
Who gave you the order? Say her name! You raped her! You murdered her! You killed her children!
When I heard they had killed my brother's son, and his poor son, and the children.
Aemon Targaryen.
Aerys Targaryen has wed some Dothraki horse, Lord. What of it?
I'll kill every Targaryen I get my hands on.
You can't get your hands on this one, can you?
For 20 years, the Spider oversaw the campaign to find and kill me.
I want him dead. Mother and child, both.
You'll dishonor yourself forever if you do this.
Honor? I've got seven kingdoms to rule!
Then we're no better than the Mad King.
Careful, Ned. Careful now.
You want to assassinate a girl? I will have no part in it.
You'll do as I command, or I'll find me a hand who will.
Go as far away as you can. As many men as you can. Because wherever you go, Robert's wrath will follow you.
How many tens of thousands had to die because Rhaegar chose your aunt?
Yes, he chose her. And then he kidnapped her and raped her.
When your brother Rhaegar led his army into battle at the Trident, men died for him because they believed in him, because they loved him.
Rhaegar fought valiantly. Rhaegar fought nobly. And Rhaegar died.
Did you know him well, Sir Barristan?
I did, Your Grace. Finest man I ever met.
He liked to walk among the people. He liked to sing to them.
He sang to them?
Viserys never told you.
He told me Rhaegar was good at killing people.
Rhaegar never liked killing. He loved singing.
17 years ago, you rode off with Robert Baratheon. You came back a year later with another woman's son.
Find you at the feast?
Lady Stark thought it might insult the royal family to see the bastard in their midst.
I want you to leave.
I never met my mother. My father wouldn't even tell me her name. I don't know if she's living or dead.
Your bastard's mother. You never told me what she looked like.
Nor will I.
You hated that boy, didn't you? How could you not hate him? The walking, talking reminder that the Honorable Lord Eddard Stark fucked another woman.
You think highly of this boy?
Good.
Lord Commander of the Night's Watch.
A bastard by some tavern slut.
Perhaps, but that wasn't Ned Stark's way.
Must have been a rare wench to make Lord Eddard Stark forget his honor.
What is honor compared to a woman's love? And what is duty against the feel of a newborn son in your arms?
You are a Stark. You might not have my name, but you have my blood.
Is my mother alive? Does she know about me, where I am, where I'm going?
The next time we see each other, we'll talk about your mother. I promise.
House Targaryen is gone. Not a single person who shares your blood is alive to support you.
A Targaryen alone in the world. It's a terrible thing.
Mr. Aemon.
Sansa came to court this morning to plead for your life.
You think my life is some precious thing to me? That I would trade my honor for a few more years of war?
What of your daughter's life, my lord?
We all do our duty when there's no cost to it. Honor comes easy to me. Yet, sooner or later, in every man's life, there comes a day when it is not easy. A day when he must choose.
I am Eddard Stark. I come before you to confess my treason.
If the day should ever come when your Lord Father was forced to choose between honor on the one hand and those he loves on the other, what would he do?
He would do whatever was right, no matter what.
Most of us are not so strong.
When my husband brought that baby home from the war, I couldn't bear to look at it. So I prayed to the gods. Take him away. Make him die. He got the pox. And I knew I was the worst woman who ever lived. So I prayed to all seven gods. Let the boy live. Let him live. And I'll love him. I'll be a mother to him. And he lived. And I couldn't keep my promise. And everything that's happened since then, all this horror that's come to my family, it's all because I couldn't love a motherless child.
Because some of you have probably heard the story before, but we had a very long lunch with George where we told him what we wanted to do with the adaptation. And we had a 3-hour talk. At the very end of it, George said, okay, who is Jon Snow's real mother? And there was a very long pause, and I looked at Dan, and Dan looked at me, and we threw out a guess, and he kind of nodded. Then he let us take the show.